Hey everyone, I'm Rama, co-founder and CEO of TOSAI. Today we're going to create a very simple computer vision dataset that then will be trained on YOLOv7, which is the state-of-the-art object detection model. We will deploy this model to the cloud as a REST API and integrate it in a React Native mobile app, so when we take a picture of a batch of cash, we will let the AI tell us the amount. Alright, let's get started. Let's create a new project. Now, let's go ahead to datasets and create a new one. Let's call it cache. We have to collect a few images of cache and upload it to TIOS. So here I have about 100 images. Let's go ahead and click start upload. This should take a few seconds. Perfect. Now we can see that TIOS already split the dataset between the train, validation, and test sets. Below, we have a few statistics about the dataset, like the train, validation, and test sets. But let's go ahead and create a new class. The 10 bill, the 20 bill, the 50 bill. Let's change the color. Now the 100 bill. The 200 bill, the 500 bill, and finally the 1000 bill. Now we're ready to start labeling. So to enter the dataset tool, we have to click the button on the upper right corner. We select the 50 class and create the first bounding box. To save the changes, we can either click submit or press the E key. Now let's label the rest of the images in the dataset. You have to be very careful with the bounding boxes you make because they have to be as precise as possible. It only took me a couple of hours to label all the images, and here we can see the statistics of each class. Also the statistics of the train, validation, and test sets. And here we have all the images. Let's take a look. Looks good, now we're ready to train YOLOv7. Let's go to the machine section and connect a new Google Colab instance. We have to run these four simple steps. Remember to restart the runtime. Let's run the TIOS setup. Let's log in. And finally, let's copy the project key and paste it back to the Colab instance. Perfect. Now we have a free GPU from Google to train YOLOv7. Now let's create a new training session. Let's call it cache detector. We select the biggest YOLOv7 version. Select the cache dataset. And the machine that will do the training. This is the training experiment. Here we will see all the metrics from our AI in real time. Let's click start training to start the process. We can now see that TIOS is controlling the machine to download the dataset automatically and then starting the training. Now let's wait for the training metrics to come in. As you can see, they are updating automatically in real time. Let's now deploy our object detection model to the cloud as a REST API. We now select the algorithm we used, the best weights, and click Create. Let's go to the playground and select a new image to detect. As you can see, our AI is working perfectly. Let's try with a few more images. But what should we do if the AI doesn't work very well? For that, let's upload a few more images. Let's open the auto labeler, select the deployment, and click label. As you can see, this is significantly faster than labeling manually. We just have to make a few fixes to the labels. So if your model is not working very well, just upload a few more hundred images and auto-label them. Then train it again and deploy the model. We are now able to integrate the model into a React Native app. Let's copy the URL and go to the code. Here we import a few dependencies. But let's go to the important part. Here is where we paste the URL for the AI. Here's also the detect function that uses the URL to send images to the AI and receive back the detections. And here's the rest of the code. You can take a look at it in the GitHub repository linked below. But as you can see, it's very short, only 300 lines of code. Finally, run Expo Start in the terminal and scan the QR code with the Expo app.